A second wave of COVID-19 infections in India has led many states to impose tough new measures. Experts warn the cost of these restrictions is the steepest for the poor. Neha Punya reports.
Farzana and Devi live barely 10 kilometers away from each other. They've both been without a steady source of income for several months, but there's a huge gulf between the lives they lead. Last year, when India announced a sudden and strict lockdown in March, Farzana lost her job and has been struggling to find work ever since.
उसके चक्कर में काम के लिए हमें बता रखा था कि पहली तारीख से आप आइएगा अभी कह रहे हैं अभी रुक जाइए क्योंकि कोरोना चल रहा है
Her children have been forced to start working to help support the family who've been getting by on just $50 a month but for Devi the lack of a steady job has not posed a tough challenge a freelance teacher she's still able to make $800 a month whenever she does find work
that I'm privileged I have enough savings to see me through I went back to, you know, doing something that I hadn't done in decades. That is, I started writing again.
This inequality is long-standing. Before COVID-19, 10% of India's population controlled more than 70% of the nation's wealth. But the pandemic has widened this gap significantly.
During last year's lockdown, more than 120 million Indians lost their jobs and 7 million are still unemployed. While India's billionaires saw their wealth grow by 35% last year, a majority of the country's households suffered varying degrees of income losses, pushing millions into poverty.
Experts say India's income inequalities are so stark because about 90% of the country's workforce is employed in the informal sector. Here, there are no fixed incomes, no job guarantees, and no social protection. And it's this group that's been hit the hardest by the pandemic. 11 million migrant workers like Bhagwati Devi were forced to leave Indian cities last year when the lockdown was imposed. She walked for 10 days to reach her village in the central Indian state of Madhya Pradesh. Bhagwati says she had no choice but to come back to Delhi. There aren't enough jobs in her village. The government did hand out free grains to tens of millions of households last year, but critics say this wasn't enough.
कि लॉकडाउन के पहले से तो हाथी 400 रुपया 500 रुपया अब लॉकडाउन खुल गए के पहले अब हो गए 150-200 रुपया बताओ ऐसे में बच्चा पलेगा क्या होगा कि मजदूरी देगा कि मजदूरी कारट बनेगा अब तो हमें कारट चाहिए मजदूरी कारट जब ही काम चाहिए
Rights groups are calling on the government to implement a universal basic income and ensure social security to the poorest.
I think this is a moment, unprecedented crisis. It does need resources. Wealth tax is one of those ideas. And we must work on ideas of this kind. And there could also be direct cash transfers to the poor and marginalized to kickstart their livelihood again.
Oxfam calculates a wealth tax on the country's richest 900 families could bring in funds equivalent to 1% of India's trillion-dollar GDP. With the country in the grips of a deadly second wave, many regions are already imposing limited lockdowns. And many migrant workers are fleeing cities again. With cases rising faster now than they did last year, experts say that while India's rich will still be able to weather this storm without help, poor families like Farzana's will not be able to recover their losses. Neha Punia, CNA, New Delhi.